Wrestling fans, backed by popular demand, don't miss the Mick Foley 2015 World Tour when it invades the world-famous Kowloon Entertainment and Dining Complex in Saugus, Massachusetts, Friday, October the 2nd and Saturday, October the 3rd. The WWE Hall of Famer and New York Times best-selling author unleashes his trademarked wit and wisdom into his one-man spoken word show, Tales from Wrestling Past. Tickets are on sale now and include a meet-and-greet with Mick. For complete information, visit KowloonRestaurant.com or call 781-484-6002. Mick Foley and Kowloon Comedy look forward to seeing you live October 2nd and 3rd in Saugus.
This is Shelton Benjamin.
This is Harley Race.
This is Mick Foley.
This is Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff.
This is the Monster Abyss.
This is Daniel Bryan.
This is JBL, and you're watching the MWF.
Be there live.
Hi, this is Tony, Mr. USA Atlas, 06 WWE Hall of Famer, and welcome to the history of New England Pro Wrestling.
Wrestling fans from around the corner and around the world, welcome to another installment of the history of New England Wrestling. I'm Dan Marotti here at MWF Studios, just north of Boston in Melrose, Massachusetts, as we flash back to the WWE SmackDown and main event taping at the Dunkin' Donuts Center in Providence, Rhode Island, Tuesday, August the 25th, 2015. Don't forget, the countdown is on to our 14th anniversary Big Bang Birthday Bash extravaganza exclusively on BostonWrestling.com Monday, September the 28th. We have a new president, a new vice president, with announcements coming left and right. As always, we need your support in a variety of ways you can help the cause of bringing you more great live wrestling events and in-studio productions. If you haven't tried WWE Network yet, click on the link below. Within a minute or two, you'll be enjoying live pay-per-views, original programming, and thousands of hours in archive shows. For $9.99, it is the best value in professional wrestling, but right now, you can try WWE Network absolutely free for 1 month. Click on that link now. Also, use the links we have to shop with our partners at Amazon.com and WWEShop.com. No matter what you buy, even non-wrestling items on Amazon, we get a small kickback for sending them your way, and it does not increase your purchase one single penny. Help out the good guys on this one, folks. The holidays are just around the corner, believe it or not. If you're feeling generous and enjoying more than 800 free videos we have up on our YouTube channel, you can always send a donation of any size using PayPal and our BW@BostonWrestling.com email address. Every penny we raise goes right back into our live wrestling event in-studio production initiatives. Diehard wrestling fans know we have to support indie wrestling. It's the backbone of the sport. It's the foundation you build a home with. We don't have giant sponsors or cable TV contracts. What we have are wrestling fans that share the same passion we do. We hope you'll join us as our adventure continues. For main event, the primetime players defeated Los Matadores. Jack Swagger with the win over Adam Rose. Stardust victorious over Fandango. In the beginning of the Dusty Rhodes Tag Team Classic Tournament, NXT champion Finn Balor teamed up with Samoa Joe to defeat the Lucha Dragons. Zack Ryder beat Brad Maddox. SmackDown opened up with a promo from the Wyatts, with Bray explaining who and what Braun Strowman is. This guy has an awesome look, giant presence in the ring. Roman Reigns and Dean Ambrose came out. Looks to be many more miles left in this feud, and that's not a bad thing. Bringing Strowman into the picture gives the Wyatts a fresh coat of paint, especially while they're waiting for Eric Rowan to return from injury. The Dudley Boys returned to SmackDown for the first time in a decade, defeating the Ascension. After the matchup, the New Day was trying to goad the Dudleys by saving tables after the matchup. One of the members of the Ascension went through the table as a result. Kevin Owens defeated Neville in an exciting matchup. Two great young athletes we've seen WWE bring to the main roster since WrestleMania. WWE World Heavyweight Champion Seth Rollins cut a promo about the return of Sting at Raw last week as the two prepare to collide at WWE Night of Champions September 20th for the gold. Charlotte and Becky Lynch teamed up to defeat the Bella Twins. Anything. The Bellas touch is lousy at its best, and this was no exception. Divas Revolution has really stalled out because whoever is putting together the WWE Divas presentation has no idea how or why the ladies in NXT is so successful right now as far as fan support, fan interaction, fan excitement goes, and that's disappointing. Dolph Ziggler and the WWE Intercontinental Champion Ryback teamed up to defeat The Big Show And Rusev, Big Show had everyone in the world turn on him on Raw last week. Rusev had the accolade on Dolph Ziggler, and then Big Show hit him with the big punch, knocked out Rusev, and walked off. In the main event, Sheamus defeated Dean Ambrose when the Wyatts made their way to the ring, and he didn't get much help from Dean Ambrose, even when he tried to save the day, as the new-look Wyatts are hot right now. After the cameras stopped rolling, Dean Ambrose and Seth Rollins had a confrontation, a brief brawl around ringside, with Ambrose getting the best of it to send the fans home happy. Thought this was a fun, solid taping. Some of the younger fans may have been a little disappointed that John Cena or Randy Orton weren't there, and that Roman Reigns didn't wrestle, but I'll tell you this, the crowd was piping hot for the Dudley Boys, and they were really behind Dean Ambrose as his star continues to rise. How far Ambrose's star rises remains to be seen. If you're in Providence for SmackDown, we'd love to hear from you. You can share your thoughts in the comment section below. Running out of time here, fans. Until we speak again, you and yours, be well.